people with individualness. There's just a beautiful row of Aussie cars here. It's a great chance to look at the Australian muscle car scene. This is just a standard Falcon. Just a bit bland at the front, this guy. But, you know, with a 3.9 litre V8, Fairmont gear. Just a pretty sharp looking little car. And beside it, a name that's very famous in Australian motorsports is Peter Brock. A couple of Brock Commodores here. A red one and a white one sitting side by side. These are the GMH Holden things that we have in Australia. And these are really clean examples of something way back from the 80s. V8s of the day. And a really clean Fairlane going back even later. Have a look under the bonnet, just beautiful. Really well looked after and loved. That's a Fairlane. Beautiful. And there's an LTD beside it, that's even more upmarket. Look at the size of this thing. But Dad, you could say you could play table tennis on the bonnet and on the boot. They really are. See, Galaxy 500. Really, really big, beautiful motor cars. And then here, some American muscle. Sure, the rear quarter of that explains it all. Just really classic, this one. 289, a little V8 in it. And then here, right beside it, is a brand new Mustang. Have a look at that. Oh, look at this EcoBoost. That means she's a little turbocharged four-cylinder, not a V8, but still looks the part on the outside for sure. And here's a slam, little Zaxxon, is it? Definitely a fun little car.
It's an airbag.
Getting plenty of attention. 1929 Chrysler, look at that. Here's another, it's called the Group 3, Peter Brock. This guy's just a racing legend. He's from the city, from Melbourne, in Australia. But the big race here is Bathurst, and he dominated it for many, many years. So he special built some fast cars. Another clean Commodore. And then up to a Cosworth Sierra, again, made famous at Bathurst, the race here. It's a fully imported car. Yeah, there you go, Dick Johnson. That's the Ford name alongside Peter Brock. He came a little bit later. These were really, really quick, really introduction of turbos to the racing scene here. You can see under the bonnet there, beautiful, beautiful car. Here's another Aussie great, and have a look at that number plate. That's XR67. This is a 1967 XR Falcon, Aussie Ford, and this one is special because my very first car was a 1967 XR Falcon. Mine was a white station wagon. Oh, I had the Venetian in the back like that, a little aluminium spoiler on the back of the wagon. But that's the XR with the round in the taillight. The next model, the XT, had a bar across the taillight. So, yeah, my very first car, 18 years of age, got my license. And there we were, off in the XR Falcon. Put extractors on it, put mags on it, 12 slots actually on it. It was the beast. Onto a Camaro, a bit more American muscle. Another Camaro, we've got a side by side on a 350. This one's a convertible. They are nice, aren't they? On the front. And then back to Aussie again. It's a Statesman. Slightly altered, nice interior. And then we're back to American again. Here's a Chrysler. Got a bit of patina in the on the front. Yep, got Uncle Sam up there. This is our machine. Have a look at the lines along the side here. She's slammed, she's dropped down. They really are some lines. Look at the shape of this. Let's see if you can pick what it is. There's the mag. Mid-engined. It's a Ford. You can tell that by the air cleaner. Very low. She's noticeably lower. Look at the height of the cars beside it. You can pick that up. Very Ferrari looking. Still twisting your brain. It's a very unusual car, this one.
No, just looking.
I'll get around the back of it.
Please don't touch the car.
Dimitaro Pantera. Come up here and have a look. This has got the history. It's a barn find by the sound of it, so it sounds absolutely amazing. There you go. Pause on that if you want to read the story. Straight up to a bit more American muscle. All of them went small with their Taranas, still put their biggest V8s in them. Came up with some amazing cars here in Australia. It's an SS. And then it was a big Caddy. Have a look at that. Quite a machine. And across there, there's a look at a very slammed Ford pickup. It's pretty amazing. Yeah, very nice. And there's a rat run over here. I noticed this as I walked in. This is amazing. I really like the look of it. Really cool. It's a pickup. Got the rusty Esky in the back. That's a machine. In there. I love the rat rods. There's a lot of individuality in there.
Absolutely beautiful Cosworth Escort. Absolutely lovely. Absolutely lovely.
hugely popular or fan car, straight six in it. Straight into another old Holden. Lots of Aussie cars here, which I absolutely love. This is the HQ Belmont. That's like the base model. Just straight up, pure and simple. Lovely, lovely example. Really clean, nice car. It's the sort of thing people get, you know, their father's car or their grandfather's car or something like that and look after it. Don't look at that for a dash. Just amazing. Not quite as much flair as a Chevy Bel Air. Sorry, I didn't mean to rhyme then. Have a look at this beauty. Yeah. It's got a little bit more bling factor. Beautiful. XYGT. Rather non-standard XYGT. Have a look at those wheels on the back. I'm thinking she's set up to drag this one. Yeah, dip centre. Beautiful. See what we've got under the bonnet. It's a V8 with that induction pipe up the top. I'm thinking she's a turbo. Let's see where that goes. Yeah, down to an intercooler. And pretty amazing. Turbo right there. Totally built in. Looking beautiful. Through the intercooler, in through that charge pipe. Into a V8. Pretty amazing. Muscle here. That's a beautiful engine though. Oh my gosh. That's amazing. A big V8 in it. Again, Aussie Tirana. Lovely colour. But, again, these were the cars of the day. The lighter the car is, let's face it, the faster it's going to go. Then right here, Galaxy 500 390. Big engine, normally aspirated, big heavy car. These big powerful V8s of the day would not be able to keep up with the standard SUV or something sold now. Now here is a very unique car. Yeah, I'll let you have a look, see if you can recognise the lines and what it is. Got a big crowd around it. So here we go, back on this car again. She's quite the machine. Got the big American boot on the back. And I can tell you she's 1975. And now...
This big is a 1985 Zimmer Golden Spirit.
There you go, you're getting your commentary. So you can have a look and have a pause on that if you want to see what it is. 1975 Zimmer. Here, this is an early Falcon. One of the very first Australians. Early first Falcons, we had an XK to start with, then an XL, then an XM, XP, XR, XT, WXY, they just go on. This one is either, I think that's an XK. So one of the very, very early Falcons to come to Australia. And again, it's really got some shape, it looks the part. So not come to Australia, made in Australia. These guys. Beautiful old cars, lovingly restored. Look at the love that's gone into that. Okay, that's it for me. Can't really move to get any further. But that's the motor show for this year. That's 2019 Father's Day show here in Acorn Street. And I think it's an absolutely beautiful car. I just love the Aussie representation there. So I hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, stick up a like and subscribe if you want to see more videos. We've got some more colour here. Look at that. Straight beside the size. Oh my gosh, those cars are huge. That's another Chevy. I'll tell you what, it looks an awful lot like an Aussie Fairmont at the time. Sorry, probably just four in some people's minds. Right beside a GTS Monaro. Very classic car. Another big Chevy. Wow. $150 spent on the engine. That's cool. Chevy. Got that roof chopped or not. Very gangster chopped looking. Looks amazing. Aussie ute. That's what's been missing here, hasn't it? Ute. It's a classic Sandman ute. Beautifully restored. And then just the old standoid HTT Commodore again. Classic in their day. Having quite old things. And then just a standard Piranha. Again, Australian staple. Finishing off with a little Escort. Something classic.